this is Munson with Munson Music. I'm going to talk about how you can play a song called Morning Song by the Avett Brothers. And we ended up cabling this on 4th fret to kind of match the recording. We'll walk through a couple things in root position just in case you know how to cable. And we start off with kind of this main intro around a G major chord. And normally you do this first finger on the A second, second finger on the low E third, third finger on the high E third. And if you strum all those together, it sounds a G major chord. It sounds really happy. Now you may also dig on putting the third finger on the B third, pinky on the high third, kind of working that for your G major. And we end up doing a lot of the G, and then we go to a C major. And normally you do this first finger on the B first fret, second finger on the D second, third finger on the A third fret. And if you strum the A string to the high E string, that sounds a C major, and it sounds really happy. Randomly around C's in general, you may want to think about lifting the first finger and bringing it to C major 7. Or you could add in the pinky on the B third for C major 9 and kind of say some stuff around the C. Or another way to play C major 9 would be doing first finger on the D second, second finger on the A third, third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E third. If you strum the A string to the high E string, that sounds a C major chord. You will hear a lot of little licks around those chords through the tune, and a lot of those licks are coming out of a G major scale. And randomly, if you're kind of interested in throwing out some of those licks, you may want to experiment with kind of open E, second on the low E, and then third foot on the low E would be an E and F sharp and a G note, which are all part of the scale. E, F sharp, G, and then open A, second fret on the A is a B note, third fret on the A is a C note, open D is a D note, and then second on the D is a E note, fourth fret on the D is a F sharp note, and then open G, then we got second on the G is for an A, open B, and then first fret on the B for a C, third fret on the D for a D, or on the B for a D note, open E, second fret on the high E for F sharp, and then third fret on the high E for a G note. So it's your sound of Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do if you started on a G note. G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G, F sharp, E, D, C, B, A, G, F sharp, E, D, C, B, A, G, F sharp, E, F sharp, G. I just throw that out there because a lot of times on the G chord in general, you will hear a lot of this low E string second fret note of sharp leading into the G chord through the tune, which might be a cool thing to kind of throw in. And randomly, you could almost do that same idea from the B note on the A string to help lead into the C chord. G, F sharp leads the G, F sharp leads the G. You'll kind of hear these cool little licks, and it starts off with this open D string, open E, open B, and then third fret on the B string. It's kind of like a little melody you'll kind of hear around the G chord, so you want to even experiment with other places in that scale to kind of get some of those notes to ring out through the tune, or even taking those notes and trying to add them to the chords. And I'm just kind of doing that with right hand muting, kind of laying my hand down, and kind of working an 8 down count on each chord. Kind of G, 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 C. Might be a cool thing to experiment with for yourself, kind of say some stuff around those chords. Or you could use a strum pattern. And one of my favorite strum patterns for a 4-4 like this is down, down, up, up, down, up. So we took the G and just tried that a lot. You'd have down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down. There's a couple ways you could kind of apply that to that intro. You could do it as a really slow paced down, down, up, up, down. G, down, da, 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 G, C, kind of an idea. Or if you're quick enough, you could almost do kind of a times two idea, kind of G, da, 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 G, 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 C, C, kind of an idea. Or what really kind of matched the feel for myself was something called a 16th note strum pattern. And what I mean by that is if you're tapping your foot to the beat, right now we're dividing that beat into two parts that are down, down, up, up, down, up. And that's called an eighth note. What a 16th note is where you divide that into four parts. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. And one of my favorite 16th note strum patterns is a long down, 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 up, up, down, down, up, down. And what I mean by that is if you take the G and do it down for four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. That's what you'd be doing on the first beat. And on the second beat, you do it down on one, down on three, up on four. So you go one, two, three, four, down. One, two, down on three. So one, two, three, four, one, up, down, one, up, down, one, up, down. And then on the last beat, you go down, up, right along with the one, two, three, four. So down, 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 down. So all together, you got our verse part, which is kind of a variation of that. Actually, we kind of start off with our G, and then more G, and then we make our C change, and then we get back to G, more G, C, back to G, and then from there, then we'll be going into our chorus part. And our chorus starts off with almost that intro idea, kind of that G. First finger on the B first fret, second finger on the D second, third finger on the G second. If you strum all those together, that sounds like A minor. It sounds really sad. Now around A minors in general, though, you may want to think about lifting the first finger, making that A sus 2, or you can add in the pinky on the B third with an A suspended, kind of say some stuff around that chord. Or you could lift off the third finger for an A minor 7, or you could add in the pinky on the high E third for an A minor 7, or you may dig on an A 7 sus by doing first finger on the D second, second finger on the G second, third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E third. You're gonna work in that for A. And it's kind of weird, we kind of half our strumming on the A minor. You may want to do just four downs, and then we go to C for four downs, A minor for four, G for four, and then back to A minor for four, and then C for two, but then there's a quick hit to a D major chord. And normally you do this first finger on the G second, second finger on the high E second, and third finger on the B third fret. Show them the D string to the high E string. That sounds a D major chord. It sounds really happy. Around the D in general, you may want to think about lifting the second finger and making that a D sus 2. Or adding in the pinky on the high E third for D suspended, kind of saying some stuff around the D. And it is a little weird timing wise there. You may want to do the A minor for 4, C for 2, D for 2, and then we end up on the G chord. Or if you're doing your down, down, up, up, down, up, you do the A minor for down, down, up, C for down, D for down, and then G with the whole power. Or if you're doing the 16th, you do your A minor for a down, 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 up. And what I was digging on was C with a down, down, up, D with a down, down, up, and then G with the whole power. Those parts until we get to our bridge, and on our bridge we go to the A minor, but then we go to an F major chord. I normally do this as a first fret bar. We'll talk about some easy options here too, but then two on the G second, third finger on the A third, pinky on the D third. Strum all those together, the beautiful sounds of F major. Now if you're just starting out, a good substitute for that can be F major 7, where you do first finger on the B first fret, second finger on the G second, third finger on the D third. And if you strum the D string to the high E string, it sounds an F major 7 chord. It sounds really groovy heavy. Or you may even dig on an F major 13, doing first finger on the G second, second finger on the D third, third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E, kind of working that for the F. So on the bridge, we kind of have our A minor for our whole count. Our verse part, but now in the key of C, actually, which is kind of cool. So we got kind of a C chord, and more C, part is to play along with the Avett Brothers. Instead of starting on a G chord, they're starting on a B major chord. So to play along with the recording, what you want to do is take a capo, and if you put the capo on 4th fret, then now your G is really a B major, and your C is really an E major chord, and your A minor is really a C sharp minor, and your D major is really an F sharp major, and the F major is really an A major chord. But to take it from the very beginning, you may want to play around with just that intro with the downs, or kind of adding and subtracting those notes of the scale. G, C. Or you may be digging on the down, down, up, up, down, up, and you could do it at that really slow pace. Or you may dig on the times two idea. G, G, C, C. Or you may dig on the 16th pattern. Options we were talking about, or something else that I like to add to a song like this too is bass notes. And a lot of times on that first down of the down, down, up, up, down, up, you're throwing a bass for the chord. So the G, you'd have low E for the bass. The C, you'd have the A for the bass. On the A minor, you'd have the A for the bass. On the D, you'd have the D for the bass. And on the F bar, you'd have low E for the bass. And on the F major 7 and F major 13, you'd have the D for the bass. Even take that intro and try it as a bass down, up, up, down, up. We have G, 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 and C with an A bass. Or if you're digging on the 16th idea, you could add basses to that, and you could work it off a bass down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, or a bass, bass. Once you kind of hit that bass note, it already kind of sets that chord up. So playing around with those melody notes. To our first verse. So we have G, G, C, G, G, C, G. And from there, then we'll be going into our chorus part. Now, the weird part is where we're kind of halving things. And on that A minor C, you may want to do just a bass down up on each of those chords. Kind of working the down, down, up, up, down, up. And then the A minor with the bass down up, C, D with the downs, and then the G. So you may kind of dig on that, kind of that G, 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 C. from there, then we'll be going into our next verse. So down G. Minor G, you may want to do the A minor and then hit the G with a C G to lead into it.
A minor C G.
And from there, then we'll be going into our bridge part. So we have kind of our A minor. Arpeggios or broken chords through that part. Just playing individual notes, if you want to experiment with that. And then the G. That'd be kind of cool to kind of end it. But that's the basics of how you get strung through Morning Song by the Avett Brothers. So good luck! Wherever you are in YouTube land, this is Munson Summer with Munson Music Live, Munson Guitar Songs, Munson Covers, and Munson Jam Tracks. Thanking you for watching this video, and I hope you got something out of this video. I hope you like this video and subscribe to the channel to see lots more like it. I'm always open to your requests. If you have a song that you love, please let me know so I can write it down on the request list so I can add that to it, because there are probably other people out there who love that song too and would love to learn how to play it. So, thanks so much for all the love that you give me, and I hope that you're doing well and kind of figuring out how you can talk with the instrument. We are a small music shop in the middle of nowhere in South Carolina, and you're supporting us by watching this channel. Really appreciate all that love. So best of luck, and let me know if there's anything that I can do to help you in particular too. You can contact me on Facebook. You can leave a message here in the comments section, and I respond to all the comments that I get. So, best of luck to you wherever you are.